Welcome. In this session, we are going to develop an application to receive arguments from user interface into routes via get post request. So what next we have to do? Now we'll go to our application. And now in this application, what we want is, we want to create a user interface first. And this user interface is going to receive some parameters and is going to send information to my logical route. So what we have to do is, now this time, first of all, we'll get started with a public directory, and within this public directory, we are going to create a user interface. Let's do that. So I'm going to create a new file within my public directory. Name of this file will be, I'm going to call it as form. So let's call it as, I'm going to call it as simpleform.html. So I've created this simpleform.html file. And now what next I want to do is, I would like to view that from my, on my live preview. So now what next we have to do is, let's say we are going to get started with a simple HTML form. And within this HTML form, we're going to create a head. Within this, we are going to have a title. On this title, we are going to call it as a simple form. Then what we have, on the next line, we are going to have our body content. Within this body, we are going to define a heading, and let's call it as simple form. After this, we are going to have a paragraph. Within this paragraph, we are going to create an input. So let's say I would like to create an input. This input will be of text type, okay? Within this input, I'm going to define a placeholder. And let's say this placeholder will say, enter your name, something like this, we are going to specify. Then what we have is, we are going to have another paragraph. And within this paragraph, we are going to define another input. And let's call it as input. And this input will have a placeholder, and this placeholder will say enter your, let's say, age or something like this. So we have got this two. And third, I would like to create another form, and this form, what it's going to do, it's going to receive an input, but this time the input will be of type button. So we are going to have a button input, and value of this input will be, let's say, submit or something. And now we are going to create that input. So now within this paragraph, we have like three things available. We have a simple form, a name, age, and we are going to submit value through this form. Okay. So now you can see that using this brackets, it's very convenient to write your code, and you can quickly see that on the UI as well with the help of this live preview feature. So I'm going to save this HTML. Now what next I want to do? I would like to send the request from current form to my route, clear? So first of all, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a root file as well, which is going to receive these values, name, age, on submission. To do this, we will create a root within the root directory. So within this roots, I would like to create a new file. And this time, this file will be something like form.js. Let's say I'm making a root for my form. Let's call it as simpleform.js or something. Okay. So once I've created this simpleform.js, now what am I going to do? I have the form ready. Now I'm creating a root for it, for the form. So I'm going to call it as express. I'm going to require express. And once I'm done with this, we need to change that to require. Okay, now, so we have created express. Now using express, we are going to make use of the function known as router. Using this router, we are going to create a new form, and let's call it as SF, simple form. Now using this simple form, we are going to receive the requests, and to receive the request, we are going to receive the request on this showform.js. Now, as soon as we receive a request here, I'm going to receive the name and the age parameters. And whatever I have received, I'm going to view that through a request and the response. So now what we'll do, we're going to receive the request and we're going to send a response. These will be the variables which I'm defining here for the function. So once the function has been defined here, now what we'll do, we are going to send a response back, okay? So let's say I'm going to send a response.send. and we are going to send a response something like this. Your name is something like whatever the name is. We are going to send that through the response name, plus your age is. So we are going to type in something like this. We are going to concatenate that with age. So this will be the response which we will be sending back. We can write whatever logic we want. We can write any logic here. Let's say we can do comparisons, we can connect to database, we can do some processing, we can do any of these things. Okay. So now, once we have got this information, now we are going to export this. So I'm going to say module.exports, module.exports, and we are going to export our form. So once we have written that exports SF, so SF will be exported. So we are done with creation of our simple form.js root. Once we are ready with this simple form.js root, now we'll go to app.js in order to define this. Okay, so now we'll say if any request will come to this path, okay, and this path will be, let's say I'm going to say this path is getInfo. Let's say if somebody is going to access getInfo, okay, I'm going to redirect him to SF, okay, and what this SF will be, I'm going to set this SF here. Variable SF will be, we are going to require a file, and this file will be ./roots, and I'm going to call it as simple form. Okay, so if somebody on the URL, if he sends a request to getInfo, that getInfo will be redirected to simpleform.js, and simple.form.js is going to receive the information and is going to respond back. Clear? Is that clear? Now, so once we are done with this, now what we'll do, we have saved all these files, simple form has been done, app.js has also been saved, and now simpleform.html has also been saved. So now there is one mechanism to send parameters from this form to my logical JS code. So this data has to be transmitted from the user's end. So what we can do is, we can simply make use of jQuery, and in order to do that, what we can do is, I'm going to get the content delivery network jQuery, and using that script, I'm going to write a simple jQuery function which will transfer data from form to my logical file, which is my root. So we can quickly do that. We can simply type in jQuery CDN. You're going to get the CDN from the website w3schools.org. So we'll go to this website. On this website, we'll get link to the CDN, the content delivery network script. And here, the CDN is available at Google. So we are going to get that script. Okay, we'll copy the script. Now we'll go to our code here. Within the head, I'm going to specify this JavaScript, this script for jQuery. And after the completion of my body code, now what am I going to do? I'm going to write another script here. Okay, and within this script, now I'm going to write the jQuery code. Okay, so in the jQuery code, what I need to do is, I need to refer the document. I'm going to refer my web document, and I'm going to execute a function ready. So as soon as my function is ready, now I'm going to execute a function. Okay, so as soon as my document is ready, I'm going to execute a function. And within this function, what am I going to do? I'm going to check if somebody is going to click my button, I'm going to receive the parameters, and I'm going to send this to getInfo/name/response. Okay, so to do this, I need to specify IDs to my input controls. So first ID will be name. ID will be name here. For the next one, ID is equal to age here. So these will be the two parameters which I will be sending. And the third ID for this button will be submit. let's call it as submit. So this will be the ID for my submit control. So once I have specified all the three IDs, now what next we have to do is, we are going to select the document. This document will be your submit. As soon as you click on submit, some function will be executed. As soon as we click on it, we're going to execute some function, and this function will be, now what next we'll do, the function will be, I'm going to get the information, I'm going to get the name first inside a variable, and this I'm going to get from the ID name. So I'm going to access the name control. This is the HTML control. I have accessed that, and now what am I going to do? I'm going to get its value, and I'm going to store that in my variable name. In the same way, I'm going to access age, and I'm going to access my document, and this document will be hash age, and I'm going to get the value. So whatever values we get now, now I'm going to send a request to the URL, and this URL request will go to slash get info. Okay, so I'm going to send a request to get info. Then what am I going to do? I'm going to concatenate my name. I'm going to concatenate another slash. Then I'm going to concatenate age. So this information will be sent to this page. Okay. Once it has been sent, now what we will do? We are going to get a function. Okay. And within this function, what we'll do, we are going to receive a response. So let's say we are going to get the response here. So whatever response we'll receive, we are going to alert the response. Okay, so we are going to execute the jQuery function, and we are going to alert the response which has been sent from the server. So now I have saved it. This file has been saved. One more thing I'm going to do. As soon as my document is ready, I'm going to give a simple message in order to check whether jQuery is working or not. So I'm going to give one alert here as well, and let's say I'm going to call it as jQuery works. So this is a simple test for jQuery as well, whether jQuery has been imported in my application code here or not. So now we are done. So now before proceeding, what we like to do, first of all, I'm going to stop my server. And I'm going to check if I have any issues or any errors in the code. So I'm going to compile and run the project again. In case if there is any issue, we are going to debug that. Otherwise, we are going to test our logical code first. Then we are going to test the front end. So now, if the project does not have any error, we are going to get our www running. Otherwise, we'll see if we encounter any errors. So now you can see that our compilation has been done and our server is listening. Now what next we can do is, we can go to the URL, we can search for localhost 3000, and we can go to get info, and within this get info, what next we'll do, we are going to provide a name. Let's say I have provided a name Devanshu, and I have to provide age, and I would like to say, let's say the age is somewhat like this, a value 10, and as soon as I have sent a request here, now we are going to check what will be received here and what response will be generated from my service, from my root. So a request has been sent here. Name is not defined. So what we'll do, we'll just quickly check. We have some issue with the reference error that name is not defined on line number 5, on line number 32 on simple form. Let's just have a look why it's just displaying that. It's like line number 5 and column number 32. Name is not defined. Let us just check that. So we'll just go to the browser here. And here what we have is, we have the code written here for simpleform.js. So here what we are seeing is, we have got SF. We have received a name and an age. Okay, actually what we did is, why this name has not been defined, because we have to get that from the request parameters. I have not created any local variable here for this name variable. So what I can do is I have to quickly access that from request.parameters.name. So this name belongs to the request, the get request which I have received here. Okay. In the last case, what I did was I have taken these request parameters and stored into a local variable name.
Same for age.
Same for age. So what we'll do? We'll do that request.parameters.age. So now we are directly accessing the get request parameters here. So as soon as we did that, we're going to save it and we'll stop the server and we'll launch the server again. So as soon as we launch the server again, now we are going to test our application again. So when the server is running, we're going to test our application. Now our server is running, so we are going to send the request back again. And now once we send the request back, so you can see that my get info is pointing to simpleform.js and it is responding that your name is Devanshu, your age is 10, somewhat like this. Clear? So we are done with this particular part. Now what we have to do is we'll go to the form and we are going to check that form should send a value and this JS file should give me a response and then it should be alerted in a alert using an alert pop-up. So what we'll do, now we'll go to simpleform.html, let's say. That was the page which we designed. So jQuery is working, we have got a pop-up, okay, jQuery works. And now here in the name, let's say I'm going to type in something like, some name like Salman Khan or something and age is something like 50. So once we submit that, so the value has been set to get info, Salman Khan, and the age has been sent, but it has been received through app.js into your simpleform.js file. Then simpleform.js has prepared a response and he has sent the response back to your HTML. And once you have got that response back, we have displayed that response using alert box. So this is how the front end UI is now connected to your logical code. And you can see that here the variables does not display the file names. So hence it offers you more privacy for your application development as well. Earlier what happened was if somebody gets to know what file you are accessing, they can go to that file and they can open the code. Now in this case, they need to know how Node and Express is working, only then they'll be able to view which particular file you are accessing. And the next part is, client will never have access to the files which are available on the server. And client can never guess as well what file could be there on the server. So it's quite difficult in order to identify the path. So whatever your paths will be, you can automatically send requests to get info and get info internally will read the request from simpleform.js and will respond you back with that. So I hope you understand how this UI application is connected to your Node server. Thank you for watching.